Have you ever wondered if that 1911 penny or Mercury dime that you've been keeping forever is actually worth something?
You know, sometimes I think finding change and going through my purse, I wonder, is this anything of value?
Sure. Mm-hmm. You don't want to be passing up something that could be. You know, I love finding out about antiques and collectibles, and right now experts in the area of coins and currency are in Battle Creek.
Emily Plott is with the International Coin Collector Show, and she's here. And Emily, ever since you walked into the studio, Rachel and I have been peppering you with questions. Is that really what your life is about, when people find the line of work you're in?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I get asked questions on a daily basis from anybody who I come into contact to when I tell them what I do for a living.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And what is the most common question you get? Maybe what to look for, or what exactly is valuable? How do you know?
Well, the big thing that we always look for as a company, when it comes to our coins, we look at our dates. Each coin has their own rarity about them. Like I was talking to you earlier, it has everything to do with how many of them were made in that year. Now, if you didn't have a rare one, it was common, your big coins are going to be your silver coins and your gold coins and your silver ounces and such like that, because gold and silver are at their all-time high.
And that's interesting, because you do a lot with focusing on coins and on money. Mm-hmm. You also do have a lot now to do with gold and purchasing these items from people.
Mm-hmm. Correct. Yep. A lot we actually have seen so far, quite a bit of gold jewelry come through our show. We only had it yesterday, was our first day of the week, and we've seen quite a bit come through. A lot of people were very happy when they left.
Oh, I'm sure.
Having idea that they had that much. And that's probably the most rewarding thing about the job, is really kind of giving back to the community when a lot of people come in with things they don't really believe are valuable, and it turns out that it is.
Okay, so what are a few things that you could mention that would be things to watch out for if they end up in your, you know, purse, or perhaps in your change jar?
Okay. The most popular stories I get when I see customers are, I collected these since I was 15. I used to work at the grocery store down the road, and I would just trade them out if I found any silver coins. Silver coins are the most popular ones to get right now, because even if they're not rare, they still hold silver value. So, and I think a lot of people knew that back when, and now people are still doing it. And I try to, and customers that I have that don't know about it, I'll try to tell them, look in your change every day. You'll be surprised at what you can find in there.
Interesting. So tell us how the whole process works, because people don't need an appointment. Mm-hmm. You're there and you're available. People should just bring their stuff and walk
exactly.
Right in.
Well, what we have, our show is set up. We have two tables with two buyers. I'm one of the buyers, and then Scott is another buyer on our team. And then we have our manager's desk at the front. Now, what happens when you walk in, we give them a number. We have them come and sit down with us. It's very personable. I think that's my favorite part about it. It's not just walking into a front desk and having to deal one-on-one when you have a line behind you and such. But now, this time, you really have the time to sit down and chat and really get to know the story and the history behind this person's collection. And that's what makes it really fun, too.
So you're at the Comfort Inn in Battle Creek. Mm-hmm. There's one item here on the table I was asking you about, because it's the only paper piece of currency that you have here. Mm-hmm. Tell us about this.
This is a Confederate dollar. Now, Confederate money was actually a very popular item to collect. One thing to look out for, it is the most replicated, and it was back then the most replicated. One thing to look for, if you do have an item like that at home, you want to feel the texture of the paper, because it's actually supposed to be extremely thin and very, very easy to rip and tear. So I put mine in a plastic case so that doesn't happen. Also to make sure to know that it's real, it'll also have detail on the back. This one does not have detail on the back, so that's the first indicator that it isn't real, but I just think it's a cool reason for our display.
I've never seen that before. Mm-hmm. That is really interesting.
Really cool. Well, and you have a website, and you're part of the Michigan team, so you travel around, and people can really find it easy to get in touch with you, even if they can't make it to this show, which, by the way, is open through September 3rd, so you're there for quite a while.
Yes.
You have a great website as well, with lots of information.
Yes, our website will give details on everything you need to know. We have a research team also that you can email and such if you have any questions about certain items you have, or if you just want to send in a picture and ask them how much it's worth. A great, great company to work for, and everybody helps out really well, and I like it.
We've learned a lot today,
so
Emily.
Really interesting. I'm a big coin jar. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to start looking at my pennies now, because you said there's one that's worth almost $2 million.
Yes, that would be the 1943 penny made out of copper.
Okay.
I'm looking at all my pennies now.
From now on. I usually
just chuckle. Not anymore.
Well, Emily, thanks.
Thank
it's been really
welcome.
Fascinating. Good luck getting out of the studio, because we got 1,000 more questions for you.
We'll be right back.